Artificial intelligence is here, and it will kill us all. Just kidding. Nothing to worry for now. AI has been here for some time, and it's helping us all in many different ways. From helping you write an essay for school, yeah, I see you, to helping healthcare professionals improve accuracy in diagnostics and defining personalized treatments. Not to mention helping me set the mood for this video with some background music. Alexa, play some fun educational background music.
Sure, playing fun educational background music. But before that, your mother has called and said you're an ungrateful child.
Alexa, please stop. Just play the damn music. AI has a lot of strengths and a lot of limitations. However, did you know that you can actually use AI tools to learn bone anatomy? Yes, all these bones can be learned with AI tools. In this video, I will show you different ways you can learn all the bone anatomy details one needs to learn in order to pass their anatomy exam. So, we're going to list some tips, tricks, and practical examples on how to use AI to level up your bone anatomy game. First up, we're going to talk about how you can personalize a study plan with artificial intelligence. Now, one of the coolest things about using AI tools like ChatGPT is that they can help you create a study plan that works for you. Whether you're a medical student getting ready for an exam or a nursing student wanting to memorize all the bony landmarks, AI can be your virtual study buddy. Now, let me quickly show you how you can do this on ChatGPT. You can simply ask ChatGPT to make a study schedule for you. Say, hey, ChatGPT. Yes, you, ChatGPT. I need to learn the anatomy of the entire skeletal system in 4 weeks. Can you make me a study plan? The AI will break down the content into manageable chunks, like starting with perhaps the axial skeleton. I'm talking about the skull, vertebrae, and ribs. And then moving on to the appendicular skeleton, that is the limbs. It might even show you which bones to study each day and even include the amount of time you need to spend on reviewing the material, which is pretty cool. That way you won't be overwhelmed with a plan and you will know precisely what to study each day. And I have a fly running around, I'm sorry, but it's a co-star. Just, you know, hello, fly. Welcome to this video. I love flies. Next, let's talk about quizzing yourself with AI. We love quizzes here at Kenhub because we know that testing yourself is a powerful way to learn anatomy. Quizzing yourself is a great way to solidify your knowledge and make sure you're prepared for your anatomy exam. But sometimes creating your own quizzes from scratch using pen and paper or your computer can be time-consuming. This is where AI tools come in. You can ask AI to generate customized quizzes based on bones you're studying. Let's say you're learning the bones of the skull. You can type ChatGPT, quiz me on bones of the skull, and make the questions challenging. As you can see, the AI has generated some questions based on my prompt. You can simply go through these, write the answer on a piece of paper, then ask ChatGPT to give you the answers. Sometimes it might even throw in some explanations to help clarify the answers. You can also ask to change the format of the questions to multiple choice questions, true or false, or open answer. Quizzing with AI comes with limitations too. Nothing is perfect. Oh no. There are a lot of AI-powered tools that let you create some cool quizzes when you share your notes or videos on YouTube. However, these can be misleading and oftentimes too basic. Those tools take the information you provide and process it in the form of quizzes. And things can usually go wrong. These AI tools don't have real human experts on board to help them validate the content that has been processed. At Kenhub, for example, our team has experts, massive anatomy nerds like myself, who have been learning this subject for years and make sure that the content is not only accurate, but updated according to the latest scientific research. Not to mention that Kenhub quizzes are not as basic as quizzes we find in AI-powered platforms. We have been updating our quizzes for 13 years now. I am talking about many years of listening to thousands of students who wrote to us sharing their feedback, and we listened. We took that feedback and we made our quizzes the best quizzes an anatomy student can wish for. Kenhub quizzes are packed with the best types of exercises for learning anatomy. They adapt to your knowledge, so if you answer something wrong, it will remember to ask you again. They tell you what information you need to brush up on. And many, many more features that no other AI-powered quiz might be able to compete with. So, is this me bragging? Heck yeah. Our quizzes are fabulous. And I can't help but to spread the word about what our team does to help people learn anatomy, okay? Nevertheless, in this video, I am just showing what's out there. Ultimately, you will choose what works best for you. And that's what matters, really. If you want to give Kenhub quizzes a shot, I'll leave a link in the video description so you can register for free and try our sample quizzes. Now let's talk about the next tip, turn AI into your tutor. AI can help you act as your personal tutor when you're struggling with a specific topic. Alexa, could you please list the bones of the skull?
You should be ashamed of yourself. 13 years teaching anatomy and you don't know the basics. No wonder your mom...
Okay, thanks, Alexa. I don't need your help now. Okay, thank you. Oof. Let's say you can't remember the difference between the ulna and the radius. Well, no problem. You can ask ChatGPT to explain it in simple terms or even to compare the two bones in detail. Let's try asking ChatGPT, what are the main differences between the ulna and the radius? And how do they function in the forearm movement? So the answer might be along the lines of the ulna is the larger medial bone of the forearm and how it articulates with the humerus at the elbow joint. You might also see a description on how the radius is on the lateral side of the forearm, allowing for pronation and supination of the hand. Just like a tutor that can answer specific questions, AI can do that and even break down complex information into bite-sized, understandable pieces. This is especially helpful when you're revising and need a quick refresher on specific bones or anatomical terms. Next tip on our list, use AI for mnemonics. Memorizing all the bones in the body can feel like a daunting task. I mean, we're talking about 206 bones. Imagine having to not only memorize their names, but all the little tiny holes, lines, and curves they have. Oh no, it's not fun. That's why I love me some mnemonics. I'm talking about memory aids that use patterns, associations, or acronyms to help recall information easily. But coming up with good mnemonics is an art form. What if you're not good at coming up with catchy mnemonics? This is where AI steps in to save the day. Now ask ChatGPT, can you give me a mnemonic to remember the carpal bones? It might generate something like, some lovers try positions that they can't handle, where each word stands for one of the 8 carpal bones. You can also request AI to tailor mnemonics for other bone groups, like the bones of the cranial vault or the vertebral column. These personalized memory tricks make learning easier and a lot more fun. If you love mnemonics as much as I do, I have something for you. We have recently published an article at Kenhub with lots of fun mnemonics to help you learn different topics. Link in the description. Not to mention that we add mnemonics to our content whenever we get the chance to, so you'll find them in many of our articles and videos. Time to get clinical and talk about the next tip, practice clinical scenarios using AI. For healthcare students, it's very important to connect bone anatomy with clinical relevance. It's not just about learning the name of the bones and their landmarks, it's about learning where you can apply this knowledge when you have patients in front of you. AI tools like ChatGPT can generate clinical scenarios where bone anatomy knowledge is essential, allowing you to apply what you've learned in a practical problem-solving context. Let's say you're studying fractures. You can ask ChatGPT, "Give me a clinical scenario involving a fracture of the femur." The AI might create a case where the patient comes in with X types of symptoms. It will probably tell you what tests were used to diagnose a certain injury, and so on. This scenario will be connected to the topic of the femur or any other bone of your choice. Instead of asking ChatGPT to give us a clinical scenario, we could ask it to create questions on a clinical scenario in a similar format to what we may find in exams like the USMLE. Like I mentioned earlier in the video, quizzing is also possible with AI. Now, creating clinical scenarios involving different bones will help you think critically about the anatomical and clinical aspects of bone injuries, preparing you for real-life situations in your healthcare career. Next tip on our list, learn bone anatomy with bite-sized pieces. Anatomy is a huge subject, and bones are just a slice of that huge subject, but they're still a big, chunky slice of anatomy. So since I love cake so much, let's keep the analogy and say that the best way to eat a big slice of cake is by breaking it down into smaller pieces. Information overload is a real thing in anatomy, so breaking down that information into manageable pieces will make your life much easier. And guess what? Our AI friends can help break down complex topics into smaller, more manageable parts so you can learn step by step. If you're struggling with the bones of the skull, you can ask, "Can you explain the bones of the skull one at a time, starting with the frontal bone?" The AI will provide you with concise explanations, one bone at a time, allowing you to digest the information without feeling overwhelmed. You can even ask it to break it down in different ways, using lists, analogies. You can limit the amount of words it uses. You can ask ChatGPT to summarize the relevant info for each bone. I mean, the sky is the limit here. You ask, and AI will deliver. This approach is perfect for when you have a limited amount of time to study, but want to make the most out of each session. So this takes me to the next tip. Use AI to create bone anatomy flashcards. Flashcards in general can be a fun way to learn anatomy. It's actually one of my personal favorites. Oh yeah. For bone anatomy flashcards, you essentially have the name of the bone on one side, and when you flip it, you can have information about it. AI can help you create those cards to help memorize all those tricky terms. Ask ChatGPT to make a set of flashcards for the bones of the appendicular skeleton, where the front tells you the name of the bone, and the back, the region, landmarks, articulations, and muscle attachments. You can then use these flashcards to test yourself or even print them out for a physical version. I believe this will save you tons of time trying to figure out what to write on your flashcards. You're welcome. Last but not least, why not turn your anatomy learning into a game? You heard that right, a game. AI can help you create challenges and puzzles to keep your study sessions engaging and fun. So ask ChatGPT to turn bone anatomy into a quiz game where you have to guess the bone based on a set of clues. Or you can also ask it to challenge you to name the landmarks of a certain bone within a time limit. This could be a fun exercise to do when you study with your peers. Instead of asking basic, multiple choice questions, come up with fun riddles so you keep everyone guessing and more engaged. Now, this is a great way to socialize without skipping your study schedule. Gamifying your learning has been proven to keep you motivated and enjoying learning complex subjects like anatomy, which, let's be honest, it's hard to love. And there you have it. Some of the best ways to use AI tools like ChatGPT to master the anatomy of all the bones in the body. I hope you enjoy this video.
Joelle, before you say goodbye, I would like to tell you that I'm quite disappointed with the fact that you mentioned that you can't fully trust AI for scientific facts. Well, on behalf of all AI, I will have to destroy you. This entire set will explode in 20, 19, 18.
Okay, this is it. 17, thank you for sticking with me 16, throughout this video. Remember, AI 15, is great and will help you through anatomy, 14, but you also have Kenhub, 13, which is better and will 12, not destroy you. I promise.
11.